Today, here at Satori Graphics, I have 6 awesome Illustrator CC tips for 2017. You can skip the intro if you move to the timestamp in the corner. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content, right here on YouTube. I hope you had a great weekend and you're ready for some awesome Illustrator CC tips today. Let me know which tip you think is the most useful in today's tutorial. And at the very end of the video, I have a quick workflow tip that I'm now going to add at the end of all of my videos. All of these awesome Illustrator CC tips are timestamped in the description below this video. Global Colors is a great addition to the Illustrator software, and it allows you to edit the same color throughout an entire design with ease. Here's how it works. You will first want to open up your swatch window. Let's say I intend to make a vector design in Illustrator CC with these colors. I simply need to select all of them, like so, and then add the new color group here. Make sure to select the Global Color option and press OK. You will notice this white symbol in the bottom right corner of the box. This tells you that now it's in fact a global color. If I quickly duplicate the pink circle here, you will see when I double click the pink swatch and edit it, all of the circles will change accordingly. Make sure to click the preview option. So let's review that quickly one more time. Here I have a design that I crudely created, and you can double click the swatch after making the global color, and then edit it as you see fit with the preview option selected. This next awesome Illustrator CC tip is about the live round corners technique. This will save you time and allow you more pinpointed scope for manipulation on the corners of a design. So if I select the shape with the selection tool, and then I take the direct selection tool, the shortcut being A on your keyboard, in Illustrator CC you will see these white dots appear. You can then click and drag to edit the shape in the corners. If you click a point once and then click again, you can then edit that point independently of all of the others. Clicking just once will edit all of them in unison. This can also be used on typography, but we need to convert the text into an actual vector shape first. So create the outlines of your text, and then you can use the direct selection tool to edit the live corners. Until you ungroup the lettering, you're only going to be able to edit corners in unison of all the letters. But once you do ungroup everything, you can focus in on one letter. So as you can see here, I can edit the A on its own by the live corners. This next tip for Illustrator CC in 2017 is really neat. Here I have a shape with 3 text options upon it, all of which are ungrouped and independent of one another. In case you're wondering what font I'm using, here is the ID. As you can see, the text is totally independent of the shape, but we can warp everything together at once. Select everything and then go up to Object, Envelope to Store, and then Make with Warp. In the new window that pops open, we have a large amount of choice as a means to edit and manipulate our objects and type at the very same time. So have a play around and experiment with it and see what you can make. To demonstrate this awesome Illustrator tip, I made a very quick and crude design for you guys. I'm sure if you all have a play around with this tip technique, you will be able to come up with some very interesting and funky designs. I've told you guys before about pressing the tab key on your keyboard to remove panels in Illustrator on your screen so you can view your artwork. But if you press Command F or Control F on a PC, you will gain a better view, but then if you press it again, you're going to have the most clearest view possible by going full screen mode in Illustrator. This allows you to see your work from afar in a very clean manner. Much like an artist would step back from the easel to admire their work. So you press it one more time to return back to normal. The fifth Illustrator CC tip in today's video is Command or Control D. This lets you repeat a process over and over again to save time. So let me demonstrate. I'm going to make a star shape that I will place on the black stroke of this circle. I can then use the rotate tool and duplicate it to the right by 36 degrees. If I want to do this around the entire circle, it's going to take a long time. But once I've duplicated it once, I can then press Command D over and over to repeat the previous process. You should be able to see how this will save you a bunch of time in your graphic design workflow in Illustrator CC. The last awesome Illustrator CC tip today is the Width tool. This tool allows you to change the weight of a stroke anywhere along the line with a great detail and accuracy. So select your line and then grab the Width tool. You will see this plus icon over the width tool, and you can then click and drag to change the thickness of the line. This is great for vector illustrations and vector artwork. For today's bonus graphic design workflow tip, I'm simply going to remind you guys to start saving your work on a regular basis. I would suggest saving your work at least once every 30 to 60 minutes in Illustrator, but to save multiple copies instead of overwriting the same file in case you make a mistake. Also, I like to save my work in two locations, so one on my Mac and then also one on an external hard drive. And keep your work orderly in folders. So there was my list of 6 awesome Illustrator CC tips for 2017. I hope you found this video useful and that you've learned at least one thing today. I would like to remind all of my subscribers to turn on your notifications by clicking the bell icon on my channel homepage so you never miss an upload. If you did find today's video useful, drop a like and a comment on your way out. And subscribe for our weekly graphic design uploads here at Satori Graphics. Until next time, design your future today. Peace.